right, welcome back to Morning Express. And well, it's time for us to look at Tech Central. And we look at how you can leverage on technology to ensure that it works for you. Now, we do know as a country, one of the things that we're going through is famine. And we need innovative ways to ensure that we have food supply for all and sundry. And joining me this morning is Brenda Ann, who is the founder for Vertical Farming. Good morning and thank you for joining us, Brenda.
Thank you so much.
And as you can see, there is a farm right here that has been set up in record time. We have a farm that's been set up in very few minutes. Maybe you can first of all tell me what is vertical farming all about, Brenda?
Oh, thank you so much. So vertical farming is a simple way of having people plant their vegetables on your balcony or on your backyards, though vertically upwards. So you use limited space, but you can still harvest so much more compared to somebody who is doing the traditional kind of farming.
Okay. Yes. So this, if I'm not wrong, is more of farming that you would do more for your own needs, not necessarily for commercial needs.
Not really. If you want to go commercial, it's still so viable. Let's compare somebody who has a vertical farming in a small greenhouse, or let me say 30 by 8, and somebody who is doing traditional kind of farming. The person who is doing vertical farms will harvest much more compared to the person in a traditional kind of farming setup.
How is that measured? Is it measured depending based on the space that they're actually farming?
It's not really depending on the space they're actually farming, but let's say this was your farm. That's end to this end. And it means you'll only have maybe 2 to 3 rows of about 6 veggies, that gives you 18. But if you do vertical, it means you'll have 3 to 4 more layers up. So instead of having 18, you'll have 24. We can even have 48.
Wow.
Yes.
Okay, so that we understand what we're doing here, what is this contraption? What is this before us here this morning?
Before us there is an automated vertical garden. When I say automated, with this kind of system, you can actually monitor and irrigate your farm using your mobile phone, remotely from anywhere.
Wow, okay.
Yes.
Using your mobile phone.
Yes.
Before we get to the mobile phone and how it communicates with this, let's just start with this. This, I assume, is just a pipe that you've put what? What's in there?
Yeah, this is a normal PVC pipe. Within it, it's stuck with coco peat and goat manure. And we also use...
What's coco peat?
Coco peat are coconut husks that have been grounded into small pieces. So instead of using soil, we decide to use coco peat. That makes our system a bit lighter. If this was soil, trust me, this could be sagging right now.
It would be very heavy.
It will be very heavy.
Yeah, because I notice even the wires that you've used here to hold it are pretty thin.
Yes.
Okay.
So that's the benefit of coco peat. Then coco peat retains a lot of water within it. Yeah.
And does coco peat have the same ingredients as soil?
Not really. Not the same ingredients. But now the good thing about coco peat compared to soil, if you're to buy soil, then it comes with a lot of so many other things that you don't know. But now having coco peat reduces in terms of the pests you'll find, or maybe even the weeds. So what you just have to do is add fertilizer to your coco peat, and your system is set to
go. Okay, so what we have in here is coco peat, and you mentioned something else.
We have coco peat and goat manure.
And goat manure. Is there a reason why specifically goat manure? What if I have cows, for example?
Yeah, you can use cow.
So you can use any manure?
You can use cow or chicken or goat, but we prefer goat manure.
Why goat manure?
It's more, the goat eats a lot of so many other things. So the goat droppings are, it's more fertile compared to...
The other kinds of manure.
Yeah.
All right.
Compared to cow.
Okay.
But the chicken is also so very good.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So in terms of preference, chicken and goat come at the top, then
cow. Yeah.
But they can still, cow can still work.
Cow can still work.
All right. So a normal PVC tube with coco peat and the manure.
Yes.
All right. What else do we have in there?
We have Agrimax. That's the normal fertilizer for spring once they start sprouting. Then we also use the iGrow.
And what are these? Is this sukumawiki?
This is Chinese cabbage, and this is lettuce. This is still Chinese cabbage. Yeah.
Okay. So now that one has this, once you've set this up, you also have to mount it like this?
Not necessarily like this, but then we agree with the client. What do you want? How much space do you have? So you can have the PVC structure, but mostly we use the metallic structure because most of our clients have a bigger farms.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I guess this is just to give you advantage in terms of height. You know, you can use different levels.
Yeah, you can use different levels going up.
Okay. I also see we have something here. Is this a bulb?
Yeah, this is a bulb. So if you have your system like this in-house, in your sitting room, or somewhere you don't receive direct sunlight, now this is a grow light.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's not just your usual kind of bulb?
It's not the usual kind of bulb.
Okay, what does...
grow light substitutes the sunlight for the crops. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but then in other at times we have a client who just wants the normal bulb for lighting at night. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And does that work, the normal bulb?
No, that one's just for lighting. Now, it's not for growing crops.
Okay. Yeah. But now, this agro bulb...
The grow lights.
Grow light.
Yes.
Grow light.
It works.
It's a difficult one for some of us. Okay. All right, it works. And does it have, like, special... Is it a special kind of light?
It's a special kind of bulb.
Where do you get it from?
We import it from China.
Okay. So you'll provide that as well as part of the whole setup?
Yeah, it depends with the kind of setup you want. Mm-hmm. We'll agree beforehand, before we come to do the installation. Mm-hmm. Then we bring what we've agreed we'll provide.
Okay. Yeah. And I'm assuming that this grow light works for this particular setup. So if you have more, you'll probably need more grow lights.
Yeah, if you have more, you'll need more grow lights. Mm-hmm. We have this bulb. Then you have the other one that runs along the system. Mm-hmm. We have different kind of grow lights.
Okay, so yeah. Now we come to this panel that to me, as a layman, it looks like a solar panel.
It is a solar panel.
Woohoo! So I know these things. All right, what does this solar panel do?
The solar panel, mm-hmm. I say this was an automated garden, mm-hmm. so we use solar energy for our system. Mm-hmm. So it's just to charge our battery and store energy that we use for pumping.
Does it also light up the grow light?
Yes, it does.
Okay.
It can light up
the grow light. Now, assuming, because you mentioned that this I can do indoors. Mm-hmm. If it is indoors, is the light in my house enough to power this up, or does this require solar?
If it's indoor, you can use the mains current, mm-hmm. if that's okay with you, mm-hmm. to still power your grow light bulb.
Okay. Yeah. Or I guess you can also put this panel, but on the outside. Then
yeah, we can put it on the outside and still wire it inside to your house.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. What do we have in that box right there?
This is the automation module, mm-hmm. and the battery.
Okay.
Yeah. So this is where we did the programming so that it can actually communicate to your phone, to your pump and back.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, why is it necessary for me to control this using my phone?
Within the urban cities, we have people with very busy schedules. This is just an option. We have others where we have you can do it manually, mm-hmm. if you have the time or if somebody is within your home setup, mm-hmm. to actually do it for you. Mm-hmm. But this is we have people who have very busy schedules within town or urban cities. For example, Nairobi, you take 2 hours in traffic, so you leave your house at around 6 or before 6 and still get back home at around 9. At times, we travel a lot due to the different kind of jobs that we do. So this will just enable you, even if you're out of the country, you're out of town, or you forgot to do your watering in the morning, you can just send a command from the comfort of your office, and your farm is still irrigated.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's the control center. That's basically the brain for this whole setup.
Yeah, it's the brain for
everything. Okay, then I can see we also have something else down there. What is that?
This is just a tank, mm-hmm. the pump inside,
okay.
where you have your water stored. Mm-hmm. Yes.
And just to mention to those of us who are viewing at home, I can see there are pipes that are running in, mm-hmm. That I assume are the ones that supply the water to what's inside there.
Yeah, yeah, okay. That's true.
All right, so maybe run me through now, how does this connect to your phone and how does it work?
It's simple. We have an app that we developed. Mm-hmm. We call it the Ukulima Tech mobile app.
Okay.
Yeah, and it's pretty easy.
Yeah,
I have it here.
Okay. So we can actually test it right now.
Yes, you can actually test.
All right. So what I'll ask you to do is maybe just open the app. I'd like us to maybe have a view of it at home as you run us through how it works.
Okay.
And this is an app that is available on any Play Store.
Not really.
Okay.
Yes.
So how do I get the app?
Once you make an order, mm-hmm. and you want your garden automated, you can either have the manual or the automated garden. So if you want it automated, what we do, we give you the app. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
And it's customized to your system. Mm-hmm. You can share it via Bluetooth with any other person, the app, but that person will only control this.
Your unit.
Yes.
Okay.
Not his unit.
So in other words, if we are a family of five, for example, we can all have it on the app and
yes.
any one of us can independently control it.
Yes.
Okay. Run me through how the app works. Or run us through how the app works.
Okay. So when you open it, mm-hmm. you get to Ukulima Tech.
Okay. And maybe if I can just show the viewers at home what it looks like, Ukulima Tech. And not sure if we're able to get this clearly. I hope we can. And that's what it looks like once you open it. And basically, it gives you a number of details there. What are those details that we see there? I can see a telephone up there. Maybe run us through that.
Bring it back. Mm. Let me help you.
Yep. The telephone, you see the telephone up there?
Oh, yeah, it's just to show you. Mm-hmm. It rides on the normal SIM card. So basically, you can text, you can call, depending on how you want it. Though the only thing is, if you call, it will just send the command normally, but you will not talk to somebody else on the other side. Just
so
the
you
same
can voice command?
Yeah, you can voice command,
okay.
And you can text.
Okay.
Yes.
So that this unit here, the control center, has a SIM card?
It has a SIM card.
Okay, which is what you're using to control?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Then you say on.
Mm-hmm. So you've put it on now?
Yes.
And now what exactly are you putting on? Is it just the app or are you already controlling this?
I'm controlling this, mm-hmm. And I've switched on the pipe.
Oh,
sorry.
There you go. Well, what she has
Let
done right there is that she has switched on the pipes.
Yes.
And they are watering our carpet, which was not the intention. That was not the intention. It was intended to water the plants, but there you go. At least we see it works.
Uh-huh. Yes.
So
then you just say off,
mm-hmm.
Then it goes off.
Okay.
So
and
if you want,
I can, on your behalf, tell you that it has gone off. Okay.
Thank you for doing that.
Yes. Uh-huh.
Yeah, then, if you want to switch on the lights, you just say lights on. This is one of the interfaces. Mm-hmm. The other one that is very simple to use that we normally sell to our clients. After all this, mm-hmm. Let me show you how it looks.
Have you put on the light?
Not really.
Oh, not yet. Okay.
No.
Okay.
Just a minute. Mm-hmm. So the other one that we'll give to a client would mm-hmm. look like this, which is pretty simple to use compared
okay.
to the other one.
And I'll just read it out for you. It's written pump on, pump off. Pump on, pump off, or pump one, pump two?
Pump two, yeah.
Okay.
Depending
and
on
then,
the size of your garden.
Yes, there yeah. is a glow.
Yes, though okay. not all, because mm-hmm. it comes at an extra cost. Mm-hmm. So it depends with the client specification. What mm-hmm. does he or she really want
okay.
the app to do?
All right.
Yeah.
Now, is it restricted what I can grow here? Because I may not want lettuce.
Because of the weight. Mm-hmm. But now for cabbage, we've come up with a new safari.
Depending on what your needs are.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
And 25,000 would be a setup like this or a bigger one?
This is just for demo. Now that will be a bigger one. That can
feed
a family of
3 to 4.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it will okay. be much bigger.
Well, just so that I can, you know, have it in my mind, how many people would this feed, for example? Or is this purely demo? This is, you'd have to have it longer.
You'll have to have it longer. But this
okay.
can feed me alone. I can do my lettuce once in a while. Chinese cabbage,
mm-hmm.
yes.
All right. Then this, the ingredients that you've put in there, how long do they last? How many harvests can I get out of this?
With the cocoa peat, it will take you 2 years before you change it.
Wow, 2 years without changing?
Yes, but if you're using soil, you'll have to change it after every 2 harvests.
Okay.
Yeah, and the goat manure, now you'll just keep on adding the other kind of fertilizers like Agrimax.
Mm-hmm.
You can do DiGrow, still use it within the same system.
Okay.
Yes.
The other fear that many might have, especially if you're having this in your house or in the backyard, mm-hmm. is insects and things like that. How do I control that?
We also have, we call them the backyard greenhouses
mm-hmm.
that come, the smallest one is 2x2, which will enable you to actually have your system in a controlled environment, though that is optional. You can do the greenhouse, you can do the insect nets, or you can do half greenhouse, half insect nets.
Mm-hmm.
That is what we always advise most of our clients. But still, you can do it in an open air, but it will force you to spray once in a while.
Mm-hmm.
Depending on if you have a neighbor who has crops or something, or it's near a fence, yeah.
Those could affect.
This
now,
could affect.
In a case where possibly I'm doing this outside, would I still need the glow light to be part of the...
This is still optional.
Mm-hmm.
Like I said, most of our systems are customized.
Mm-hmm.
It depends with the client's specification or the client's needs and the advice that you give at that time.
Mm-hmm.
So if it's outside, at times you'll not even need the automation bit part of it because you can actually water it using a can.
Oh, yes, you can do that on your
and
own.
And the other option, we always have an overhead tank, so water flows by gravity.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay, so that's an option that one can
that
use.
That is also
how,
an option.
How would you control the water that's flowing from gravity?
No, we have taps, and we have what we call the mid-connectors that will actually enable you to control it step by step.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And how long have you
and
been doing this?
We registered the company last year, March.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So this year, March. Third will be 1 year old.
And what's the response generally from the public, especially in the urban settings?
When we started, people were a bit skeptical about it. But currently, people are taking it up. People have started to appreciate the fact that they can have their kitchen gardens.
Mm-hmm.
They can do their veggies. They can eat fresh salads from their gardens at any time they want. So
mm-hmm.
people are actually taking it up.
Okay.
Yes.
And roughly with the cocoa peat that is there and the goat manure or whatever manure one chooses to
mm-hmm.
use,
mm-hmm.
roughly how many harvests are you looking at in terms of using the same ingredients? Because one of the things is that if you're that busy and you actually need the automated system, I may not have time to keep changing, you know, the cockpit.
It will.
And I see the light has gone.
The light has come on.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Well, is it a command you sent or?
It's a command I sent.
Okay.
Like, yeah.
Okay.
So you can do three comfortable harvests. Yes.
Three comfortable harvests.
Yeah.
Okay. And purely vegetables. Anything else I can plant in here?
Like I said, tomatoes are it's part of fruits. Yeah, but basically it's for vegetables, and you can do strawberries.
Our strawberries as well.
Yeah. Currently, okay. We are trying out if somebody can do passion fruit, because we have the greenhouse kind of system. So if you can do passion fruit along the rails on the greenhouse, so we're still testing.
Now, if somebody wanted to do this kind of farming, but on a commercial basis, roughly how much do you think the setup would be? Because what we've talked about here is more of the domestic and more of a family who maybe wants to just feed themselves. But maybe somebody has the space in their house to do this and still this as a side hustle. How much would it be in terms of investment for me now to put up something that I can do commercially?
Let me say if I give you a system of about 6x6 in a greenhouse kind of setup, you'll invest about 250,000.
250,000.
Yeah. The initial cost sounds so high because of the kind of infrastructure, but then this is a one-off thing.
Okay. Well, I think then we normally take a vote and say whether it's something that is a hit or a miss, and we'd like to hear from you. Do let us know whether that's a good innovation and whether it is one that you'd be willing to invest in and use. Well, Brenda Ann, thank you very much. Brenda Ann is the founder for Vertical Farming. And like I said, in a day and age where we certainly are facing famine, it is something that is innovative. Response possibly, and if you have any questions, you know, is this a garden that you could use?
It was, you know, I went to buy a tomato yesterday, and one tomato was 10 shillings. So I figured, you know, if I could, I could have something like this in my house.
I think you need to go home with this.
You sort of can we have it for free? It would be
but if you need to do tomatoes on this system, then I'll give you the six inch pipe. Not the small one. This is a 4-inch pipe.
This is a 4-inch pipe. Yeah. Okay. Well, I must say that it's a very good innovation and definitely one that answers a need right now that we have in Kenya.
Yeah, I mean, these are the kind of things people need to be buying each other as gifts, Valentine gifts.
Is your birthday coming up?
Yeah, actually it is. Soon.
Oh, it is?
I will not disclose, but soon. So you should be saving up for buying these things.
All right, so you already know what Michelle wants for her birthday. This would be a good contraption, but there you go. Well, this is where we wind up the show, and well, from a very dedicated team that ensures Morning Express comes every single morning. We wish you all a fantastic and a wonderful day.
Absolutely. My name is Michelle Ngele. To join Mike tomorrow on Morning Express and Hot Topics. But before we let you go, let's just have a few comments that are coming in on Twitter regarding the show this morning. And of course, we have been focusing largely on the burial of the late Nderitu Gachagua, whose body has arrived in the country this morning. And just some tweets coming in here. The likes of Mark Coyero saying here, rest in peace, my governor. You have fought a good fight. And we also have Jeff here saying, the governor has done quite a bit. I applaud him for continuing with his work despite being sick. Many thanks for watching Morning Express and giving us some feedback this morning. And this is where we wind up the show. Do have a good rest of your day.
And do stay with us right here on KTN News. Coming up next is Sophia Wanuna, who is currently handling camera 3, which I'm talking to right now. So do stay with us right here on KTN News. For us, we'll bow out and wish you all a fantastic day. God bless.